إن الحمد لله الذي نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن لا وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help the ones who lost their lives, who lost their loved ones in the tragedy of Christchurch in New Zealand. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the ones who lost their lives and be happy with them and guide their families towards patience. It's not a loss of Islam, rather it's a loss of humanity. Death of fellow human being has become so common among us that it does not shake our hearts anymore. May Allah make it as a wake-up call for all of us, for all of humanity, and let it not fade away like all other incidents going on around the world. My dear brothers and sisters, such incidents are supposed to shake us, and when it shakes us, we start thinking of where we are in our life and what we are doing. It makes us refresh our thinking about all the accomplishments and the goals that we're running after. As humans, once we set a goal, each and every one of us has the potential to reach that goal. What many of us fail is to set the right goal in our life. There are so many distractions, so many things that keep pulling us. We get lost most of the time. As human beings, when we stay with wrong goals or no goals at all in our life, we become depressed and restless. So it is a human nature that we are supposed to have a goal in our life. But how do we set a goal? Which goal is most important to us? Which one should I go for? How do I set my goal? SMART, S-M-A-R-T, is an acronym that we can use to guide our goal setting. The goal that we set ourselves should be specific, should be measurable, should be achievable, should be relevant, and it should be time-bound. Now we are in the masjid, and today is a Friday, we're for Salatul Jumu'ah. We're here for the Salatul Jumu'ah, and it might look very normal that the khatib is gonna tell something related to Islam. But let's be neutral for a while and see that the things that we'll discuss today, are they really the one and only goal in our life or not? Let's be neutral for a while and think about it. The first thing when setting a goal is to be specific. Our goals should be clear and specific. Otherwise, we won't be able to focus our efforts or feel truly motivated to achieve it. When drafting our goals, we should try to answer few W questions. And those questions are, what do I want to accomplish? Why is this goal important to me? Who is involved in this scenario? Where is it located? Where should I go to achieve this goal? And what are the resources available? If we answer these five W questions, we can be specific about our goals. The first question, what do I want to accomplish? And I repeat, let's look at it from a neutral point of view. Accomplishing education in our life is very important. It seems like it's very important. Getting a good job, earning money, looks very important too. Being a leader in our community, having power, having authority, looks very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Zariyat, ayah 56, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ And I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship me. Now let's pause for a while and see what Allah is saying here. The one who created us calls worshiping him is our sole purpose of life. So being a true worshiper to our Creator is the one best thing any human being can accomplish. Accomplishing anything else is worthless if those accomplishments does not get us closer to the main accomplishment, which is worshiping our true Creator. All kinds of accomplishments should lead us towards that main accomplishment, which is becoming a better worshiper of our Creator. Otherwise, those accomplishments will be in vain. In Surah Al-Haqqah, Ayah 25 to 29, we see the results of those vain accomplishments. وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِشِمَالِهِ فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَهِ وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهِ يَا لَيْتَهَا كَانَتِ الْقَاضِيَةِ مَا أَغْنَى عَنِّي مَالِيَهِ هَلَكَ عَنِّي سُلْطَانِيَهِ. But as for he who is given the record in his left hand, he will say, I wish I had not been given my record and not known how my record looks like. I wish that the death in the world was the end of me. My wealth has not been of any use of me today. And my power and authority that I possessed has vanished. My dear brothers and sisters, all our accomplishments, our education, our job, our leadership roles in our community, etc. in life should revolve around the main accomplishment, which is to be a better worshiper of our Creator at the end of the day. Otherwise, this education, this wealth, this power and authority that we possess will go in vain. So our main accomplishment should be to be a true worshiper of our Creator. May Allah be merciful with me and all of us for our mistakes and our shortcomings. The next question that we need to ask is, why is this goal important? After we have a clear understanding of what we want to believe, what we want to achieve, we need to know why it is important to achieve this. As we start to see life for the first time, as we grow up, we at first are very much driven by desires. Desire to have a little more fun playtime. Desire to have fun in everything. Desire to have a beautiful spouse. Desire to have a lot of wealth. Desire to be greater and powerful than this other person. But as we keep moving on in our life, we understand that the only thing that matters is that little peace in our life. Little peace in our relationship with our spouse. Little peace with the relationship that we have with people around us. If anybody looks carefully, he or she will notice that everything that the Creator wants us to do has in fact a long-lasting effect and a peaceful effect in our personal life, in our social life, and in overall humanity. So becoming a true worshiper of our Creator is only for our own benefit. That's why achieving this goal is important. The next question that we ask is, who is involved in this scenario? When we talk about education, who is involved in the scenario? The student and the teacher. When you talk about job, who is involved in the scenario? Me and my boss. When you talk about achieving the goal to be a true worshiper of our Creator, who is involved in the scenario? It's us, either individually or collectively, and our Creator Himself. It looks very simple, but actually it's very overwhelming if we have a true understanding of who our Creator is and His attributes. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. The one whose words, if sent down upon a mountain, it would shatter in fear. He is involved in this scenario. الله نور السماوات والأرض. The one who is the light of the heavens and the earth, he is involved in this scenario. يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون. The one who created us and those before us, the one who spread out the earth for us and built the sky, the one who sent water down from it and with that water produced things for our sustenance. There's the one who is involved in this scenario. كيف تكفرون بالله وكنتم امواتا فاحياكم ثم يميتكم ثم يحييكم ثم اليه ترجعون هو الذي خلق لكم ما في الارض جميعا ثم استوى الى السماء فسواهن سبع سماوات وهو بكل شيء عليم. The one who created for us all that is in the earth, then he turned to the heavens and made them seven skies, and he is the knower of all things. He is the one who is involved in the scenario. May Allah be merciful with me and with all of us for our mistakes and shortcomings. My dear brothers and sisters, at the end of the day, our main goal is to be a true worshipper of our Creator. And reaching this goal is easier if we keep our eyes open about our Creator. So far, we know what we are trying to accomplish, why that goal is important, and who is involved in this scenario. The next question that we ask is, where is it located? Where do I go to achieve this goal, to be a true worshipper of our Creator? Where do I go? In many of our faithful brothers and sisters, worshipping the Creator is limited to four or five rituals only. Some of us has limited worshipping inside a building. To us, our Creator is only worshipped inside the masajids. But if we see clearly, it is our Creator who has called us to establish prayer, and it is also He who has spread out the provision for us and told us to go out and put our effort in. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Then once, roughly translated to, then once the salah is over, disperse in the land and seek the grace of Allah and remember Allah abundantly so that you may be successful. So earning for livelihood is also worshipping the Creator. What comes next is actually the problem that comes in our mind is when people, while earning livelihood, become greedy and want more and more and start earning by cheating others and being unjust and doing injustice to others. That's where the problem is. But earning livelihood is also worshipping our Creator. So where do we go to be a true worshipper of our Creator? We lead a normal life, abiding by all the guidelines that our Creator has sent down on us. The next question, to have our goals specified, is what are the resources available to achieve this goal that we want to achieve of being a true worshipper to our Creator? What are the resources? It would be a total misery if our Creator left us alone in this life. It is only normal that the one who created us has guided us and provided us with the resources to serve the purpose of our creation, which is to be a true worshipper of Him at the end of the day. In Surah Baqarah, ayah 38, we see that when our Creator sent Adam alayhi salam to this life, He promised to send down guidance also. قُلْنَا بِطْلُ مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Go down from here, all of you. When guidance come to you from me, those who follow my guidance shall have no fear, nor shall they grieve. In Surah Baqarah, beginning of Surah Baqarah, Allah says, Alif Lam Mim, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This is the scripture in which there is no doubt, containing guidance for those who are God-conscious. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. Who believe in the unseen, keep up with prayer, and give from what their Lord has given them. وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. Who believe what has been revealed to you, O Muhammad, and what was revealed before you, and have found faith in the life hereafter. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدَمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ These are the ones who are truly guided from their Lord, and these are the ones who is truly successful. Dear brothers and sisters, to serve the purpose of life, we accomplish the greatest accomplishment. We need to go back to the words of our Creator for guidance. That's the resource that has been given to us to accomplish this great goal. So my dear brothers and sisters, by asking the five questions, what do I want to accomplish? Why is this goal important to me? Who is involved? Where can we go to achieve this goal? And what are the resources available? We have specified that the one true mission, one true accomplishment that we can run for is to be a true worshiper of our Creator. All other accomplishments should revolve around this one true accomplishment. Otherwise, those accomplishments will go in vain in the day hereafter. So we have our goals specified. The next thing that comes in the word smart is achievable. Sorry, measurable. In the word smart, after being specific, the next thing that comes is measurable. Is the goal measurable? Of course it is. What is the scale of measurement? We want to be a true worshiper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Creator. How can we measure where we are? In Surah Ahzab, ayah 21, we see, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ Surely there is a good example for you in the Messenger of Allah. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا O Prophet, we have sent you as a witness and as a bearer of good news and a warner. وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا And as one who calls people to their Creator by His permission and as a bright shining lamp. In Surah Isra, ayah 95, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَمْشُونَ مُطْمَئِنِّينَ لَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَكًا رَسُولًا Say, if there were angels walking down on earth, feeling at home, we would have sent them an angel from heaven as their messenger. So if we want to measure ourselves where we are in achieving that goal, which is to be a true worshiper of our Creator, we should measure ourselves against the Prophet that Allah sent down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The trick that goes in our mind is that they are prophets. And those were the golden times. We cannot possibly be like them. That trick that goes in our mind. If angels were here, Allah would have sent angels as messengers. We are humans and Allah sent a messenger among us so that we can measure ourselves and see where we are and what we can improve on. So yes, our goal, it is to be a true worshiper of our Creator, and it is measurable. The next letter that comes in the word smart is achievable. Is our goal achievable? The goal that says to be a true worshiper of our Creator at the end of the day. My dear brothers and sisters, we see the lives of Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in, that for a human being to be a worshiper of Creator is achievable. Here also the same trick plays, that those were the golden people and those were the golden times. We cannot possibly be like Sahaba radiallahu anhum ajma'in. We cannot be. But in fact, it is the opposite. Rather, they have proved that for a human being, it is completely possible to have a life accomplishing the true mission, which is to be a true worshiper of our Creator. So it is achievable. The next thing that comes in the word smart is it relevant? The goal that we are running for, is it relevant? We are here in this world with sole purpose of being a true worshiper of our Creator. And we have this one life to work towards it. The time which is already gone is never going to come back. So we need to make our efforts, make the most of our time. Staying depressed over the past will only make us waste the present valuable time. So we need to keep on working every moment on becoming a true worshiper to our Creator. This is the most relevant thing that we can become. This is the most relevant thing, that the goal that we can set for ourselves. Everything else will fade away over time. This is the sole purpose of us being created. The next thing that comes along in the word smart is time. Is it time bound? And there is not much to say, because we all know, of course, we are bound by time. We never know when we'll go away from this earth. We are here for a short term. We came here, and one day we're going to die. The trickiest part is that we don't know when we'll go. We can die any second now. We can die today. The angel of death will come at any time. That makes it so important to immediately start working on achieving the goal that we discussed today. The people that lost their lives last week might not possibly have imagined that that day was their last day of their lives. They might have had parties or family reunions planned for later that day. Little did they know, that was the last few moments of their lives. They might have had family gatherings planned, but their time ran out, and it was their time to say goodbye to all the relationships that they valued so much. Who knows when our calls will come? We don't know. It might be today, it might be tomorrow, next week, next year, nobody knows. So yes, this goal that we are trying to achieve, it is time bound, and the clock is ticking, and we don't have much time. There should be in our mind. So my dear brothers and sisters, if we think for a second neutrally, we'll see that our only goal is to be a true worshiper of the one who created us. And each and every one of us agree to this actually in our heart. This goal is specific. This goal is measurable. This goal is achievable. This goal is relevant. And we are bound by time to work on this goal. Let us keep this goal in our mind always alive. Let us live and live our life accomplishing things that will help us reach that goal, and not make other accomplishments bigger than this goal itself. Because inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, from him we came and to him we'll return. I say these words, but I have done mistakes and I'm full of shortcomings myself. May Allah be merciful with me. May Allah be merciful with all of us and guide us in the life for a better living. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear brothers and sisters, we have discussed today that our goal, without a goal, a human being will be depressed and restless. And the goal that matters to us most is to be a true worshiper of our Creator at the end of the day. And to be a true worshiper is not limited to four walls for a certain time. It is to live our life abiding by all the regulations, all the guidance that are sent down upon us. And this goal is specific. Everything else that we want to achieve, that we want to accomplish in our life, should revolve around this goal. All the accomplishment, our job, our education, our power and authority that we possess should lead us towards becoming a better worshiper, not take away from it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us and to make this goal all the time in our mind. Help us keep this goal in our mind all the time. May Allah make it easy for all of us to work towards it and to run towards it. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر كلمتنا عند الموت بلا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. وأقيم الصلاة.